Hello everyone, I'm Mrs. Sunita Dole. Topic covered here is bottom-up parsing, LR parsing. In this video, we are going to consider bottom-up syntax analysis technique that can be used to parse a large class of context-free grammar. Learning outcomes. At the end of the session, students will be able to know about LR parser and parse the string using LR parser. LRK is a bottom-up technique to parse a large class of context-free grammar. The L is for left-to-right scanning of the input. The R is for constructing the rightmost derivation in reverse. And K is for the number of input symbols of look-aheads that are used in making parsing decision. When K is omitted, K is assumed to be 1. LR parsing is attractive because LR parser can be constructed to recognize virtually all programming language construct. LR parsing is most general non-backtracking shift-reduced parsing. The class of the grammar that can be parsed using LR method is proper subset of the class of the grammar that can be parsed with the predictive parser. And LR parser can detect a syntactic error as soon as it is possible to do so a left-to-right scan of the input. The principal drawback of this method is that it is too much work to construct an LR parser by hand for a typical programming language grammar. For this, specialized tool called LR parser generator is required. It covers wide range of grammars, SLR, that is simple LR parser, then canonical LR, that is most general LR parser, LALR, that is intermediate LR parser. SLR, LR and LALR work same, only their parsing tables are different. SLR is easiest to implement but the least powerful of three. Canonical LR is the most powerful and most expensive, and look ahead LR is intermediate in power and cost between the other two. A schematic of LR parser is shown in figure on the slide. It consists of input, output, a stack, a driver program and a parsing table that has two parts, action and goto. The driver program is the same for all LR parser, only the parsing table changes from one parser to another. The parsing program reads the character from an input buffer one at a time. The program uses a stack to store a string of the form S0, X1, S1, X2, S2 and so on up to XM, SM where SM is on the top. Each XI is a grammar symbol and each SI is a symbol called state. Each state summarizes the information contained in the stack below it. The combination of the stack symbols on the top of the stack and the current input symbol are used to index the parsing table and determine the shift-reduce parsing action. A configuration of an LR parser is a pair whose first element is the stack contained and whose second component is an expended input. S0, X1, S1 and so on up to XM, SM stack contained. AI, AI plus 1 and so on up to AN input. SM and AI decides the parser action by consulting the parsing action table. Initially, stack contains just S0. And configuration of LR parser parsing represent the right sentential form X1, X2 up to XM, AI, AI plus 1 up to AN dollar in essentially the same way a shift-reduced parser would. Only the presence of state on the stack is new. LR parsing action. If the action SM, AI is equal to shift S, the parser execute a shift move entering the configuration S0, X1, S1 and so on up to XM, SM, AI, AI plus 1 and so on up to AN dollar. So this derives to S0, X1, S1 and so on up to XM, SM, AI as comma AI plus 1 and so on up to AN dollar. Here the parser has shifted both the correct input symbol AI and the state S on the stack. If the action SM comma AI is equal to reduce A derives B, then the parser execute a reduce move entering the configuration given here, where S equals to go to SM minus R comma A, and R is the small r is the length of B, the right side of the production. The parser first pop two R symbols off the stack, exposing the state SM minus R. The parser then push both A, the left side of the production, and S, the entry for go to SM minus R comma A, onto the stack. The current input symbol is not changed in a reduce move. The output of a LR parser is generated after a reduce move by executing the semantic action associated with the reducing production. If action SM comma AI is equal to accept, parsing is completed. Error: parser detected an error, so that is an empty entry in the action table. Algorithm LR parsing: input and input string W and LR parsing table with function action and go to for grammar G. Output: if W is in language of that grammar G, a bottom up pass for W, otherwise an error indication. Method: initially a parser has S0 on its stack, where S0 is the initial state and W dollar is in the input buffer. The parser then execute the program until an accept or the error action is encountered. In this algorithm, four moves are explained, which we already considered on the previous slide. Initially, set input pointer IP to point to the first symbol of W dollar. Repeat forever. Begin. Assume that S be the state on the top of the stack and A the symbol pointed by the input pointer IP. If action SM comma AI is equal to shift S dash, then push A then S dash on the top of the stack and advance the input pointer IP to point to the next input symbol. If action SM comma AI is equal to reduce A derives B, then pop 2 into length of beta right side of the production symbols of the stack. Let S dash be the state now on the top of the stack. So push A, then go to S dash comma A on the stack and output the production A derives beta. Else, if action SM comma AI equals to accept, then return. Else error. Consider the grammar: E derives E plus T, E derives T, T derives T star F, T derives F, and F derives E or ID, and the parsing table for this grammar. In this parsing table, SI means the shift and the stack state I, RJ means reduced by production numbered J, ACC means accept state, and blank means error. On the input ID into ID plus ID, the sequence of the stack and the input contained is shown on the slide. At the line number 1, LR parser is in state 0 with the ID the first input symbol. The action in row 0 and the column ID of the action field in the parsing table is S5, meaning shift and cover the stack with the state 5. This is what happened at line number 2. The first token ID and the state symbol 5 have been pushed onto the stack and the ID has been removed from the input. Then star becomes the current input symbol and the action of state 5 on the input star is to reduce by F derives ID. Two symbols pop up the stack, one the state symbol and one grammar symbol. state 0 is then exposed. Since the go-to of state 0 on F is 3, so F and 3 are pushed onto the stack. We now have the configuration given on the line number 3. Each of the remaining moves is determined similarly. So till now we consider LR passing algorithm. Now pause this video and reflect on this question for a minute or 2 minutes and write your response. Once you have written the answer to this question, then you can restart playing this video. The question is, pass the string ID into ID using LR passing table. I hope all of you have completed this activity. How to pass the string using LR parser is given on this slide. This is the reference used for preparing this presentation. Thank you.